हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। दिस इज माय गिराज हियर एंड नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गेट डिस्कस अबाउट द रेजोनेंस एंड क्वालिटी फैक्टर्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द रेजोनेंस? सो दिस इज द स्पेसिफिक कंडीशन फाइंड आवर इन द एलसीआर सर्किट। दिस इज वीएल, दिस इज वीसी एंड दिस इज वीआर। सो अ पर्टिकुलर कंडीशन whenever XL minus XC becomes 0. So for LCR circuit, Z is equals to under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So Z is equals to R square plus 0. So Z is equals to R. Means it is a specific condition whenever the difference of inductive reactance and capacitive reactance becomes 0. Means in the LCR circuit, VL and VC attach oppositely with each other. Then in some time, this condition may be created that VL may be equals to VC or XL may be equals to XC. So this is the particular condition when the phase difference is 180 degree between VL and VC or XL and XC. So then such a condition create whenever XL become XC equal to XC, then this is the resonance state. So for the resonant condition, whenever capacitive reactance and inductive reactance becomes equal or which are attached oppositely with each other, then the impedance of the LC circuit will be equal to the ohmic resistance, and this condition is known as the resonance. And the frequency by which is formed in this condition is known as resonance frequency. So for this condition, XL equals to XC, this is equals to omega naught L and this is equals to omega naught C. So omega naught square LC is equals to 1. So omega naught square equals to 1 by LC. So omega naught equals to 1 by under root LC. This is the angular resonance frequency. And if we put 2 pi F naught equals to 1 by LC, so value of F naught is equals to 1 by 2 pi under root LC. This is known as resonance frequency. Okay? So now let me draw the graph for resonance condition. So here we will consider some specific conditions like for resonance curve. Let me consider here L equals to 1 millihenry means 10 power minus 3 henry. C equals to 1 nanofarad, that means 10 power minus 9 farad. If we take this, then angular frequency that will be equals to 1 by root LC. So if we put this value 10 power minus 3 and 10 power minus 9, so it will equals to 10 power 6 radian per second. So in this condition, angular frequency will be in terms of mega radian per second. And let me consider here the specific condition, R is equal to 100 ohm. Second condition resistance is 200 ohm. So for both value, voltage is 100 volt. So whenever we solve the maximum value of current Vm by R, this is the maximum voltage. So 100 upon 100, that is 1 ampere. And this is the second condition. So 100 upon 200, that is 0.5 ampere. So here, let me draw the graph. Here, let me consider the inductance is 10 power minus 3, 1 millihenry. Capacitance is equal to 1 nanofarad. So after the solving the angular frequency, that is equal to in order of 10 raised to 6 radian per second or mega radian per second. Here, let me consider resistance. Two condition of resistance, 100 ohm and 200 ohm, where the maximum value of voltage is 100 ohm. So we obtain the two value of current for which we will draw the curve of resonating condition. Here the angular frequency in terms of 10 raised to 6 radian per second or mega radian per second, and this is the value of current. So here two condition. First one is 1 ampere. That is equal to this one. This is the for first condition when R is equal to 100 ohm. And now this is the second value of current, that is 0.5 ampere. This is the second value of resistance, that is 200 ohm. So this is the resonating curve. Here for the same value of maximum current, we will form here two value of the frequency or angular frequency. So we can also say that for the resonant condition, it may be formed more than one value of angular frequency. So this is the curve of resonating condition. And now let me discuss here the quality factor. Quality factor or Q factor or QF. So for the LCR circuit, for LCR circuit, I equals to V upon Z, that is equals to Vm upon under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square. This is the first equation. But Im max is equals to Vm by R, or simply we will put this value. I max means Im is equals to Im max by under root. This is the RLS value. So it is also the putting value of Im max. So it is equals to Vm upon under root 2R. So this is the second value. Okay. So on comparison of both equation, Im, Im, Vm, Vm. So this value is equals to this. Comparison of first and second equation. So R square plus XL minus XC whole square is equals to under root 2R. So squaring both sides, and it will be obtained 2R square. So XL minus XC whole square equals to 2R square में ये R square minus हो जाएगा, so R square बचेगा. XL minus XC is equals to plus minus R. Okay, so we can also write this XL minus XC equals to plus R and XL minus XC equals to minus R. Let me discuss here the first condition here. Both you can also solve both condition, but here we are going to get discussed about the first condition. XL minus XC equals to R. Okay, so this is equals to omega L minus this is equals to omega C is equals to R, and we can also write this is omega 1, and the value of this omega is equals to omega naught plus delta omega. We can also write this, the different values for this. Okay, so we can also put this value, and omega 2 is equals to omega naught minus delta omega. So agar aap ye condition solve karte hain, dekhiye use kar lijiye, ye humne first condition le liya, to first condition ko lekar ke solve kar rahe hain. So putting this value, omega naught plus delta omega L minus 1 upon omega naught plus delta omega C is equals to R. Okay, so omega naught common ले लीजिए, so 1 plus delta omega upon omega naught L minus 1 upon omega naught बाहर, ये C भी बाहर है, 1 plus delta omega upon omega naught is equals to R. अब ये value ऊपर ले जाएंगे, और ये ध्यान रखिएगा, omega naught L is equals to 1 by omega naught C. So 1 by omega naught C जहाँ पर है, वो उसकी जगह हम ओमेगा नॉट एल यूज कर सकते हैं, 1 प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट माइनस ओमेगा नॉट एल, 1 प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट पावर माइनस 1 दैट इज आर। और इसको अब हम 1 प्लस एक्स पावर एन इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस एन एक्स से ओपन कर देंगे बाय द बाइनोमियल थ्योरम। ओके, सो इट विल बी रिटन एज ओमेगा नॉट एल, दोनों से कॉमन ले लीजिए, 1 प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट माइनस 1 माइनस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट इज इक्वल टू आर। इसको सॉल्व कर दीजिए, ओमेगा नॉट एल 1 प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट माइनस 1 प्लस डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट इज इक्वल टू आर। सो इट विल बी रिटेड एज ओमेगा नॉट एल इंटू 2 डेल्टा ओमेगा अपॉन ओमेगा नॉट दैट इज आर। सो इट इज इक्वल टू 2 डेल्टा ओमेगा इंटू एल इज इक्वल टू आर। ओके, दिस इज द रिलेशन ऑब्टेंड बाई अस। सो हियर बैंड विड्थ, दिस इज द इक्वल टू 2 डेल्टा ओमेगा दैट इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा 1 माइनस ओमेगा। सो व्हाट इज द बैंड विड्थ? The difference of both angular frequency is known as bandwidth. Okay, so the difference of both angular frequency is known as bandwidth, and quality factor is equal to the ratio of initial angular frequency and bandwidth. Okay, so this is equal to omega naught upon 2 delta omega. This is equal to the quality factor, the ratio of initial angular frequency and bandwidth is known as quality factor. So here the value of 2 delta omega is equal to R by L. So putting here, thus QF is equal to omega naught upon R by L. So it is equal to omega naught L by R. Okay, so you can simply say that quality factor directly proportional L and quality factor inversely proportional to R and quality factor inversely proportional to the band width. Okay, it means bandwidth जितनी कम होगी उसका Q factor उतना ही ज्यादा होगा। Okay, or you can say that the quality factor is more and more as well as the bandwidth is low. Okay, in this way this is the quality factor that is equal to omega naught L by R. Thank you.